invite His Excellency Mr. Rapulane Molekane, Ambassador and Permanent Representative to the United Nations in Vienna of South Africa. Excellency, you have the floor.
Thank you very much, Chairperson. At the outset, let me extend my delegation's warm congratulations to you on your elections as chair of the 63rd session of the Commission on Narcotic Drugs. To this end, I would like to assure you and your bureau of my delegation's unequivocal support. I also express my delegation's sincere appreciation to the Secretariat for diligently preparing this session. Chairperson, South Africa maintains that the fight against the world drug problem remains common and shared responsibility, which requires enhanced international cooperation rather than confrontation. Drug abuse negatively impacts on the health of the people, undermines socio-economic developments, and destroys the moral fiber of societies. Therefore, it behoves our collective and shared responsibility to tackle it in all its form and manifestation. It is in this context that my government reaffirms its commitment to the implementation of the international drug control system, as underscored by the ministerial declaration adopted at the 62nd session of the Commission of Narcotic Drugs, taking into account its midterm review in 2024. Our annual gathering here in Vienna is therefore testament of the political will of our countries to give practical effect to the implementation of this policy in the hope to fulfilling the desires and aspirations of our people in ridding the society of this scourge. Chairperson, my government noted the global trends that drug use remains multifaceted in nature and characterized by concurrent use of several substances, including the use of conventional plant-based drugs, synthetic stimulants, and opioids. In this regard, we call on the international community to adopt innovative approaches to address these challenges. Like many countries, South Africa is not immune to the scourge of drugs. We are cognizant that vulnerable groups, particularly children, youth, and women, are impacted significantly by substance abuse. Chairperson, in addressing this scourge, my government continues to accelerate the implementation of prevention and treatment programs targeted at the vulnerable groups. This initiative include a comprehensive prevention campaign flagship focusing largely on the youth and with the slogan "Kimoja, I am fine without drugs." This program was developed in collaboration with the UNODC. Furthermore, my government has significantly expanded treatment services by increasing state-owned treatment centers. I am pleased to share with you that treatment centers are now accessible throughout the 9 provinces in our country. Chairperson, our efforts to address the world drug problem will not achieve the desired outcomes until we have disrupted, dismantled, and neutralized the national and transnational criminal networks behind the illicit drug trade. In this regard, my government is cooperating closely with other government law enforcement agencies and judicial authorities in the region, and we want to foster a collaborative approach. We continue to increase the confiscation of illicit drug consignment in various ports of entry, which are destined for other parts of the world. We are also making significant inroads in detecting and dismantling clandestine drug laboratories to reduce the supply and availability of drugs. My delegation would like to take this opportunity to express sincere appreciation for efforts in the handling of the process relating to the recommendation from the Expert Committee on Drug Dependency relating to cannabis, and to commend member states for upholding the Vienna spirit of consensus on this matter. While my government has carefully considered and reviewed this recommendation and is already in a position to support the WHO-ECDD recommendation as they relate to cannabis, my delegation will continue to work with member states in arriving at an amicable solution. We are equally grateful to you, Chair, for guiding the process leading up to the streamlining of the annual report questionnaire that would assist member states to share information accordingly. Let me conclude, Chair, by encouraging the UNODC to continue to provide technical assistance and capacity building to member states, particularly developing countries, in the formulation of the implementation of integrated, balanced, comprehensive and evidence-based national policies and programs in the fight against the world drug problem. I thank you.